In this video, I'm going to show you four different advanced interaction elements you can choose from when creating Google Chat apps: slash commands, dialogs, preview links, and message attachments. Hi, I'm Chanel, a developer advocate at Google. If you're curious how you can start building chat apps, this video walks you through some of the more advanced interaction elements you can use when building Google Chat apps. This is the third in a series of three videos that cover the anatomy of Google Chat apps. Slash commands are a way for users to interact with your chat app's features. For instance, if a user types slash help, you could present them with a list of all the possible slash commands and the description of what each command does. In the Google Cloud Console, where you configure the Google Chat API, you can define your app's slash commands. For every slash command, you define a name, a unique identifier, and a description of the command. You can also define if the slash command should open up a dialog. You'll find out more about dialogs later on in this video. When the user invokes your app by slash command, an additional field is attached to the message sent from Google Chat to your app. As you can see on screen, this field indicates that the user selected a slash command, the slash command's ID, and an annotation. The command ID that your app will receive corresponds to the command ID that you specify for that command in your app's configuration. This allows your app to handle slash command cases explicitly with limited argument parsing. If you're looking for a way to collect structured information from your users or to configure your chat app settings, you should try out Dialogs. You can create dialogs with the Card Builder tool. In an upcoming video, we will show you this tool in depth. To help users complete multi-step processes, apps can open up sequential dialogs. Let's say a user issues a slash command. In this case, your chat app receives an event from Google Chat that looks like what you see on screen. The key is dialog event has the value of true. Depending on if a user opened a dialog, clicked a button in a dialog, or canceled a dialog, you will see the corresponding value for the dialog event type attribute, which you see on the right side of the screen. Your chat app can then respond with a dialog by returning an action response of type dialog with a dialog action that includes a JSON description of the dialog. On screen, you see an example of how this could look. When the user completes the form and submits it, a card clicked event is passed with the message payload having a dialog event type of submit dialog. On screen, you see an example of how this could look. Once your app receives this, it processes the form inputs fields that contain the values the user chose in the dialog. After receiving the dialog form data, the chat app should respond by either acknowledging the receipt or by returning an error message. On screen, you see an example in AppScript of the app checking for the presence of a name value. If it's absent, the app returns an error. If it's present, the app acknowledges receipt of the form data and closes the dialog. When collaborating together in a Google Chat space, users often share links that lead to other third-party tools like a support ticketing system. With link previewing, you can enable your chat app to preview a link by attaching a card to the user's message. When someone adds a link to the message, a chip appears which lets them know that a chat app might preview the link. After sending the message, the link is sent to the chat app, which then generates and attaches the card to the user's message. Alongside the link, the card contains additional information about the link, including interactive elements like buttons. Your chat app can update the attached card in response to user interactions like button clicks. The preview can be removed at any time by clicking Remove Preview. You can enable the link previewing in the configuration of the Google Chat API in the Google Cloud Console. Register specific links like example.com or example.com/cases/ as URL patterns so your chat app can preview them. When a user's message contains a link that matches a link preview URL pattern, the link gets sent to your chat app as the matched URL attribute on the message object. By checking for the presence of the matched URL attribute on the message object, your chat app can add information to the message with the previewed link. On screen, you see an app script example of how the chat app could reply with an attached card to the previewed link. Your chat app could also reply with a simple text message. Now let's say the user clicks the button "Assign to me" in the link preview card. How can your chat app update the card to reflect the user's action? As we previously saw, our card already contains information on what to do when a user clicks a specific button, like "Assign to me," as we can see on screen. Note the property "onClick" and the property "function" that has the value of "assign." By returning an action response of type "update user message cards" and taking into consideration the action method name, the chat app can update the card attached to the previewed link. Users can send your chat app's messages that include attachments like Google Drive files or uploaded files. On screen, you can see an example of a JSON representation of an attachment. Can you spot what type of attachment this is? Have a look at the last property in the object. We can see the value "uploaded content" for the source property. So this is a local file that the user uploaded to the chat app. The attachment data ref field contains the resource name of the attachment. You can use this information to get the attachment from the media API. Here is an example of the JSON representation of a Google Drive file attachment. The source field contains drive file, and the drive data ref field contains the file ID of the attachment. We've covered four different advanced interaction elements you can choose from when creating your own Google Chat apps. About which elements would you like to learn more about? Let us know in the comments section below. Want to learn more about Google Chat apps? Then check out the Google Chat for Developers documentation linked in the description. There you will find easy to follow along samples to get you started building your own Google Chat apps. Subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming Google Workspace development or AppSheet videos. Stay tuned for future videos where I share more information on how you can create your own Google Chat apps.